What is one of the hardest things when you're living in a van down by the river? Internet. And today I have a solution to help resolve that very issue. If you are new to the channel, we invite you to hit that subscribe button down below and ring that notification bell for future videos. If you are a returning subscriber, I want to thank you for coming back. And please, everybody, if you can, hit that like button to help this video get seen. Internet is one of the biggest issues for being mobile. And today I wanted to share my updated setup that I use to help overcome this issue. I am a remote computer programmer for one of the top cancer research hospitals in the country. So being connected is a must for me on a day-to-day basis. Plus, with a YouTube channel, being able to upload and download videos as needed is crucial to keep this thing going. Added bonus for this setup I'm about to show you is that you are not locked into any provider. So that once you've got the product set in place, you can go around from SIM card to SIM card provider and do whatever you need to whoever's offering the best deal at that time. To start with in this video, I'm going to focus more on the product side of it, and then we will roll into the service provider side of it and cover more of that in detail. I do want to say I am not affiliated with any of the companies that I will be discussing today, whether that be Mobile Must Have or WeBoost. I have no affiliation with either one. Now, let's jump in and get this video started and see what you all think about this new setup I have. The first part of my setup is the WeBoost Connect RV65 signal booster. The setup starts outside with my 25-foot telescoping pole and antenna that you see here. I then run the wire into my slide to get it inside, and I'll show you what that looks like in there. So this is the wire coming in from the slide outside. It comes in here, and this is where the wiring is actually housed when we're in transit. But you can see it starting to feed back through the wall there. It runs behind the TV, behind the cabinet, and then through these cabinets here, and you can actually see it come out here. From there, it comes through here and connects to the booster, which connects to the antenna sitting right beside of it. And what this is doing is ensuring I'm pulling the best cell signal possible. So it's helping my phone and it's helping the PEP wave at the same time. I have a full product review of this, and we'll include the link in the video above, as well as the Amazon link for the product in the description. This thing has worked like magic all by itself since we got it. We love it. I do highly recommend the WeBoost Connect RV65. To anybody who is looking for some sort of a booster. The thing is amazing. Now, on to the great new piece of this equipment that is helping keep me connected to the internet and keeping things going well for us. This is the PEP Wave Max BR1 router with Cat 6 LTE sold by Mobile Must Have. I will include a link to this product down below in the description to the Mobile Must Have website. In the past 6 months, several channels have done reviews on the Mobile Must Have products, including Changing Lanes and You, Me, and the RV, to name a few. They did amazing videos, but their videos are on the high-end, high-cost PEP Wave Cat 18 setup. This is actually the Cat 6. The Cat 18 is great, and it does offer many additional features, but in my opinion, you can cover most of your needs with a Cat 6 and save a ton of money. This PEP Wave system, if you buy it through Mobile Must Have, without the antenna that they try to sell you, will run you around $600. And the Cat 18 system runs between $1,200 and $1,500, depending on the options that you get with it. Since I already had this antenna, I didn't get the antenna that originally goes with this because I didn't want to have to put more stuff on the roof, more holes in the RV to get the antenna ran down. This has worked perfect for me. So I think if you've already got an outdoor booster antenna, you can really get by without the antenna that goes on the PEP Wave. And as I stated before, what I love about having this booster and this here is not only am I getting better signal to the PEP Wave, but I'm also getting better cell coverage to all the cell phones in the house by having this here. With the antenna that goes with this, you do not. It is a separate antenna that only feeds into the PEP Wave. So that's another advantage to this. And on this router here, the one thing that I do love about it is it actually has a slot, and it's back here, and I will try to pop up a picture to show you, but it can handle two
SIM cards at a time, and you do have failovers on them as well. You can set priorities up on these, so if one internet's not doing good, you can move to another one. So if you got Verizon and AT&T, you can have AT&T as a priority, and if it's not doing good, you can move back to the Verizon. You know, so, and it'll do it all automatically, which is really cool. And the cool thing about this is the PepWave is automatically set up. It does work with Verizon, AT&T, T-Mobile, or Sprint. I know two of those have merged there, but it does work with the different SIM cards from the different providers. This router is also capable of 2.4 and 5 gigahertz band Wi-Fi, which is really cool because, like with the Togo system, you can only connect to 2.4. Well, the 5 gives you a little bit more speed, so if you can get that, it's much better. This can actually do both, and you can set those up as a failover as well, which is really neat. So you get multiple options with this system all in one. And the other neat thing is down here, it actually has a direct Ethernet port. So if you're sitting at your home base, or if you're somewhere where for whatever reason they have Ethernet that you can connect to, you can actually connect to that directly to here, get that really solid connection, and send that all the way throughout your RV, which is, to me, that's incredible just that it is an option. I know for us having the home base, when I get the fiber, I obviously plan on running the line and plugging into here. That way there isn't any concern about internet when I'm at home, and there we get good cell signal anyway, so it really wouldn't matter. I do want to say I highly recommend any of these PepWave systems that you may be interested in. Whether you're going with the entry-level Cat 6 like I got, or if you go with the Cat 18 system, I really do like the whole PepWave setup. I like what they bring to the table. And for us, we are currently using Mobile Must Have as our provider for the SIM card as well. So we've got one AT&T SIM card in here right now, and that's all we have. And that is provided through us through Mobile Must Have. And when we originally bought this, it was supposed to be unthrottled, unlimited. Shortly after we bought it, the SIM card got dropped down to 1 terabyte worth of data. And then following that, it has since then been dropped down to 500 gigabytes worth of data. And they make these changes without any real notification or warning. And I'm sure the provider's doing it to them too. But, you know, they never told us. There's actually another person I know that has this set up, and they emailed and complained about it. And that's how we found out. I won't share that out. I'll let them share that out in their own video. But, you know, it's just not very good customer service on that point. Just letting you know, and we pay $140 per month for this service, and obviously since the changes have happened, the price has not come down with the data coming down. So that's another point of frustration. And the downside to this is, the once you go over that 500 gigabytes of data, whatever the limits are at that point in time, they shut it off. There's no warning, there's no nothing. They just shut off your service. You're disconnected until the next pay cycle comes up. And then at that point, you get your service back on until you run out again. So that I was not real happy with. Luckily, we have not gone over, but you know, it's probably going to happen. And like I say, the biggest thing to upset us was they made these changes with no warnings to customers. They didn't send out any type of email or anything like that to let you know what was going on. That was pretty frustrating. And I will say, I have worked with their customer service at Mobile Must Have a couple of times, and to put it bluntly, their customer service really sucked. So if you do go with Mobile Must Have for your whole setup, then be prepared for that. You know, if you do run into a problem, so far to my point, I have not been real happy about their customer service. And the people that I know that do have this set up, none of them have been real happy either. So that is definitely something to keep in mind. Customer service is a big deal, and it just seemed like in everything customer service is fading, but this is one of those areas where I don't think their customer service is all that great. Now the good thing is, you can buy this unit and you do not have to buy their SIM card. So whether you buy the unit from Mobile Must Have or you buy from somebody else, you can put whatever SIM card from those four different providers in here and it should work. So that is the cool thing. The PepWave will work with any SIM card that you put into this system that are from those main four providers. And again, those are Verizon, AT&T, Sprint, or T-Mobile. I just wanted to make sure in telling you how good the product is, I also wanted to provide true feedback about the customer service of Mobile Must Have. That way there's no surprises when you purchase this. If you go through them, you kind of know, at least you got a heads up for what to get into. And hopefully your experience was different than mine and the few people that I know that have this. But overall, I do love this product. I love this whole combination of products together. I think it works out very good. It has served our need. It's kept us connected. We're able to do what we need to do when we need to do it. So that's why I wanted to share this out and show how we have this set up in the RV.
So once again, if you have not, please hit that subscribe button down below and hit that notification bell for future videos. Also, if you could, if you don't mind, hit that like button to help this video get shared out. Let me know in the comments below what you think about this setup, or if you have any questions about it, I will be happy to answer anything that I can. I can tell you we've had this set up now for a few months and we are extremely happy with it. It's working very well and serving all of our needs. Thank you all so much for watching today. Hope to see you down the road. Bye, y'all.